This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to do a short introduction to dimensional analysis. So let's look at a few problems and see how this works. This first problem says, the doctor has ordered 500 milligrams of medication. The medication on hand is 250 milligrams per tablet. How many tablets should be given? Okay, we set it up this way. We start out with the amount of medication that was ordered. That's 500 milligrams. We're going to be dealing with fractions, so I'm going to turn this into a fraction. I'm just going to put it over 1. You don't have to do that, but I find that it makes things a lot neater, so I like to put the medication amount over 1. I want to turn that amount of medication, 500 milligrams, into some number of tablets. So I'm going to put an equal sign over here, leave a place for the number of tablets, and write the unit, tablets, that I want to end up with. Now the other information that I'm given in the problem is there are 250 milligrams per tablet. That means that one tablet equals 250 milligrams of medication. So I'm going to take that information and write a fraction, one tablet over 250 milligrams. Now let's do a quick fraction review so we understand what's going on here. If you have a fraction and the numerator and the denominator, the top number and the bottom number, or the top amount and the bottom amount, are the same, then that fraction equals 1. And since 250 milligrams is the same as one tablet, this fraction that I just wrote equals 1. And when we multiply anything by 1, it doesn't really change it. So when I multiply the 500 milligrams by this fraction, one tablet over 250 milligrams, I'm not going to really change the amount of medication. I'm just going to change the units that I'm using. Now, I put tablets into the numerator, into the top of the fraction that I made, because I want to end up with tablets in my answer. Okay? There's another rule about fractions. When we multiply fractions, we multiply across the numerators times the numerators and the denominators times the denominators. But before we do that, we can simplify things. If we have the same number or the same unit in a numerator and a denominator, we can cancel them out. So I'm going to cancel out the milligrams. Now when I do that, the only unit that I'm left with is tablets, and that's what I want to end up with. Okay, so we could multiply now. We could multiply the 500 times the tablets, and we could multiply the denominators. We would do that and end up with a fraction which we'd have to simplify. Instead of multiplying first, I'm going to simplify these numbers first. So here I've got a 500 in the numerator and a 250 in the denominator. If I can divide a numerator and a denominator by the same number, I can simplify the problem. So I can divide both of these numbers by 250. When I divide 500 by 250, I end up with a 2. When I divide the 250 by 250, I just get a 1. I can't simplify things anymore, so now I'm going to multiply. I'm going to have 2 times 1 tablet, so that's going to be 2 tablets. When I multiply the denominators, I get 1 times 1, so that would be a 1 over here. But 2 over 1 is just the same as 2, so we really don't need to do that part of it. We just end up with 2 tablets. Okay, so all I did here was this. I started out with the amount of medication the doctor ordered. I put in an equal sign and wrote the unit that I wanted to end up with. And then I made a fraction out of the rest of the information, that 250 milligrams is the same as one tablet. I put tablets in the numerator of that fraction, so I would end up with tablets in my answer, and milligrams in the denominator, so I'd be able to cancel out the milligrams. I simplified everything, multiplied across, and got my answer. Okay, and here's another one. This one says, The order is for 1.5 grams of medication. The label reads 500 milligrams per tablet. How many tablets should be given? Okay, so we'll start out with the amount of medication that was ordered. That's 1.5 grams. And we want to turn that, we want to make that into a fraction, so we'll put it over 1. We want to turn this into tablets. So I'll put in my equal sign, a space for the number of tablets, and I'll write in that unit, tablets. My information tells me that the label reads 500 milligrams per tablet. I want to end up with tablets, so I'm going to make a fraction with one tablet in the numerator, in the top, and the denominator, the bottom, will be 500 milligrams. Well, I've got a little problem here. I've got grams and milligrams. So let's remember how grams and milligrams equate to each other. 1 gram is the same as 1,000 milligrams. So I'm going to make another fraction. That fraction is going to be 1,000 milligrams over 1 gram. 1,000 milligrams is the same as 1 gram, so I'm still just multiplying by 1. I put the milligrams in the numerator because that allows me to cancel out the milligrams that I also have in the denominator. And I've got grams over here in the denominator, which allows me to cancel out these grams over here in the numerator. So let's cancel out those units. I cancel out the milligrams and the grams. The only unit I'm left with is tablets. Before we multiply across, let's see if we can simplify this. I've got 1,000 and 500. I can divide both of those by 500. 1,000 divided by 500 is 2, and 500 divided by 500 is 1. Let me fix that 2. And I can't simplify anymore, so let's multiply. I've got 1.5 times 1 tablet times 2. Well, 2 times 1.5 is 3, so that'll be 3 tablets. The denominators are just 1, 1, and 1, so I won't worry about those. And my answer is going to be 3 tablets. Okay, so for this one, we took the amount that was ordered, we multiplied it by the information on the label, that 1 tablet is the same as 500 milligrams, and I put tablets in the numerator, so I would end up with tablets in my answer. And then I had to convert since I had grams and milligrams, so I used another fraction, 1,000 milligrams over 1 gram. Multiplied everything across, or simplified first, multiplied everything across, and ended up with my answer. Okay, I hope this helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.